Greetings, humans. Spinning Mantis here with the next episode of Stardew Valley. Thanks for joining me. Well, it is Halloween celebration today. So we're at the end of fall season. So there's going to be 10 p.m. tonight, Halloween festival downtown. So I thought we should check that out. So coming up, I think I'm going to... I wanted to play through this for like a whole year and show all the seasons. But beyond that, I don't think I'm going to continue this as a multiple day a week sort of series. I think it is more suited to being a once week series. And I will just go ahead and... one episode a week coming up pretty soon. I do appreciate everyone who does watch the series. I think I'm going to move to doing that in the future. I've already got Spinning Mantis vs. Monkey Boy Gamer in the Long Dark on Wednesdays, which is a one day a week series. And idea for a Monday series with my buddies Prister and Fred Dragon and such. So maybe do a special Monday show and a Wednesday show, and then maybe Stardew Valley would be on a Tuesday or a Thursday or a Friday. This one's still too young for milking, but she loves me. Alright, so we've got cheese working, mayo working. Haven't checked the cave in a day. Plenty of mushrooms. No. This is just good extra money. You can also use these to make potions for when you're adventuring in the mines. I did get down below the 10th level of the mines, and it does get much more difficult, and you do get attacked by a lot more monsters, multiple monsters at once. So, I do suppose that if that's what you're into, and you're gonna go and adventure in the mines a lot, making those potions out of all those mushrooms would be a very good idea. So that's not my main focus right now. My main focus is the farm. I have had plenty of resources, so that's not a problem. It's been producing a lot of honey, which is nice. Two bee boxes there. Okay. I do actually have enough now to upgrade one of my tools, which is going to be awesome. And then mayo actually makes real quick. I can actually make 4 a day. Not too shabby. Getting 4 eggs a day, I can make 4 things of mayo a day, which just increases the value of your eggs. Like, say you get $10 for an egg, you'll get $20 for mayo. That. I do kind of like the cranberries and the corn, like yields of all season, which is very nice. But then late in the season, I planted a lot of bok choy and eggplants, which only produce once. So I wanted to mention, I did, today I purchased my new house and future farm and business. So Goatsmead Farm, starting in April, will be a real thing. Right now it'll be 2 acres. We're looking to buy some neighboring acres. But it's a house and a business that I'm going to use as my studio, and eventually, in the future, it'll be a tea house, the Apothecary Tea House at Goatsmead Farm, to be exact. That sounds fun, doesn't it? Alright, so I think I've watered everything. I've harvested everything. And look at that. My cheese has already been made. So, that really is a great way to easily up the value of all of your products. And in case you wanted to see what the future Goatsmead Farm Apothecary Tea House look like, you can go check out the videos on the channel in the playlist Casas Bonitas. And it is labeled wine bar inside and wine bar outside. See, look how fast it makes the mayo. Pretty amazing. So, we do have time to kill. What are we going to do? Okay, since we have 5 bars, we're going to go over and we are going to upgrade. What are you doing over here? Are you going somewhere? Do you have any scarecrows on your farm? She's asked me that before. And when I saw her yesterday, she was all asking, like, oh, are you coming to the Halloween party tonight? I can't actually go. Well, that stinks. I was hoping that I would be able to do something and go buy some things, but apparently I cannot. So, what we're gonna do is we're gonna chop some wood. Thin out this area. Not with an axe, not with a pick. Guess maybe it's just the downtown area we can't go into. If we can go over to Marnie's farm and such. We can. So that's not a problem. Might as well pick up Shum. Hey. What, Marnie? I walk into your place of business and you're like, nah, I'll see ya. I think she does take, I think her hours are until 4. Gotta respect the hours they set. There's some forage. So there's an exotic forage kind of thing of a bob. I wonder, like, where you get those. I wonder if it's just like going to be deep in the mines or something like that, that you have to get the exotic forage from. That makes a bug when they fall onto a plane higher. Hmm. So I don't think I showed it in another episode, but look, this is a mouse who sells hats. And it used to only be the good old cap. Lucky bow. Let's go with a daisy. All right. Let's see how the lucky bow looks on us. Rather than the ball cap. Oh. No. We're not throwing away our ball cap. Look at that. We look adorable. We look absolutely adorable. Is there anything we can get rid of so we can buy the other hat? I guess the mixed seeds. Fiber. Fiber. We're buying that other hat too. We need a daisy for our hair. There we go. Go here. You're gonna rock the daisy. No. Alright, so it's getting a little bit dark. Should probably start heading back. At least be a bit closer. We're gonna drop down another tree. Wonder if those are hats I unlocked because I got certain achievements. I do think that's probably what it was. I don't think I got achievements when I bought those hats. But I got the do-it-yourself achievement, so I get this cool little flower for my hair, and that's what we're gonna rock for the time being. I'm gonna rock that. So lots of resources. Are being begotten. Alright, what can we put away? Shrooms. Go put away our resin and such. That goes away, and that, and then what we're going to do is we're going to put away the good old cap and the lucky bow. That seems okay. And we do want to grab that. No eggs hiding out. Nope. And then we can go just take these seeds, which will probably die because winter comes like tomorrow. Alright. I think it's time to go have some Halloween fun. You notice I have a glow about me. That is because I found a ring in the mines that gives me this glow so I can see better, which is really cool. All right, Spirit's Eve has begun. Ooh. Hi, Mantis. Have you had a productive fall? I have, actually. It's starting to get quite cold. Crops won't hold out much longer. It's true. But yeah, Marnie, I want to go to the maze. I'm not scared. So what's available at the shop? So it's another rare crow. A jack-o'-lantern, whimsical fall deck. That could be cool. Could probably sell jack-o'-lanterns if we do that crafting recipe. I'm actually going to buy it. Rare crafting recipes are good. Don't get close, too close to the cage. Skeletons are walking creepy. It's pretty cool though. It is. One of my rhythm infused maces make quick work of these things. So yeah. Jeez, how are they walking dead? I get scared very easily. I'll leave the haunted maze to the younger people. Vincent's upset. I won't let him go into the haunted maze, but he's just a little boy. That's the dude, right? No, it's Lee. Hi, sorry. Mouthful of blackberries. Do you like the jack-o'-lanterns? I carved them myself. I do indeed like the jack-o'-lanterns. With free grub. You won't see me in the haunted maze, though. Good evening, Mantis. Have you ventured into the haunted maze yet? It's quite spooky. That strange man who lives in the tower set it all up himself. He wouldn't let anyone near it while he was working on it. Well, there's the dude with the long hair. Well, winter's almost here. It's a good time to stockpile wood and stone. Indeed. I haven't seen Mara in hours. I hope she's alright. That does seem to be everybody. I haven't found, who's her face, though? I'm too scared. Aww. Oh, that's the haunted maze up there. I get it. So I've talked to Emily. I think I talked to everybody. I think this is all there is. Is kind of closed off. So we can walk into the haunted maze. You okay, Mara? I think I've already been this way. No, wait. I'm lost. Sorry about that, Mara. You found me. Truth is, I got too scared. I came here to hide. Ooh. That's pretty scary. Scary zombie hands. Ooh. Scary television. Exit. The vapor from this cauldron is making my head spin, but I can't seem to leave. We have a cauldron sniffing party? Interesting. We can't go in this house. I thought we could do something here. It's too bad you can't, like court people when you're in these events. Give them gifts and stuff. I don't really socialize with any of the other people except in these events. Something weird over there. But how do I get to it? Indeed. That's the question. I can't go on. on, spiders. You can go on, girl. Come on, girl. That is kind of scary. Well. Oh. There indeed is a secret passageway. The place is cool. It's odd. It's just a dead end up ahead. Because I found a secret passage. I just kind of like got the golden pumpkin and such. Kind of awesome that way. Alright, I seem to have talked to everybody, interacted with everything. Don't think there is anything else to do in this event. Talk to. I think all we can do is walk out at this point. Yeah, Mayor won't even talk to us anymore. That was a pretty scary maze. I don't think you really want to go in there, kid. Alright. That was fun. Yes, we would leave. Alright, here we are. Let's see what the heck the golden pumpkin is. Am I right? That's intriguing. A golden pumpkin. Alright, we can definitely sell the mayo. Mayo. And the wild honey. Let's go in and... I can't believe that jelly's not ready. Golden pumpkin. It's valuable, but has no other purpose. Interesting. I'm not surprised the brew isn't ready, but I am surprised that the jelly isn't ready. Alright, well that is going to be the perfect place to end this episode. I hope you're having some fun. I certainly am. If you'd like to see more of this series in the future, even if it is only one day a week, it helps me a lot if you like, favorite, subscribe, share with a friend, and I hope you join me next time. That's going to be all for now. Spinningmantis out. Namaste.